What a great day to be in your presence. We acknowledge your goodness, everlasting Father, and we ask that your word will come to us this morning. Send down the light from heaven. Flood our hearts with rivers of living water today, in the name of Jesus. The principles of success, the eighth path, part eight. Amen. If you look into the world today, even the church world, let's focus on the church world. There are a lot of people who have actually given up on life, and I will explain that. Or somebody will say, no, I've not given up on life. But you see, there is no more motivation to go forward. You just accept the status quo, right? And just leave it as it is. Do you understand me? They've given up on life. What again can come from all this? They don't say it. But like I said, they've just given up and quit on life. And that is by accepting the situation. As this is it for me. My bishop will say, never mistake your condition for your portion. Your condition is here, yes, we see it. The situations are all around you, we see it. But that does not mean that is your portion in God. Are you following me? He said, the Lord is the portion of my inheritance. Psalm 16. The Lord is the portion of my inheritance. Amen. And of my cup, that is of what belongs to me. And it is God that maintains my lot. Look at the next verse. It is God that he said, the lines are falling unto me in pleasant places. Yea, I have a goodly heritage. Can I hear you say, I have? You must know what you have. What do you have? A goodly heritage. The one that God has apportioned for me. The one that is secured for me in Christ. The one that Christ paid for with his blood. I have a goodly heritage. Amen. I have a goodly heritage. God is your portion. If you are saved, God is your portion. If you are saved, God determines your lot. If you are saved, you have a goodly heritage. What you are going through is one thing. What God has made available for you is another. Are you following me? Until you are able to bring yourself, what we are talking about is bringing yourself into the light of what God has made available for you. So don't quit on life. All you need is what we're about to talk again today, is a little more perseverance. Perseverance. It's called the fight of faith. Perseverance. Amen. Perseverance. Somebody else will call it doggedness, right? You've heard that before. Doggedness. Perseverance. There is a story in the Bible that I like using every time I talk about this. In 1 Samuel chapter 4, Israel was at war with the Philistines, and Israel was losing. Then somebody said, let us bring the ark to the battlefield, right? And they went and brought the ark of the covenant to the battlefield, and they were rejoicing that God has come into the camp. And then the Philistines heard them shouting and said, what's going up there? And they said, they have brought the ark. And the Philistines themselves knew what that meant. Right? The Philistines said, they started shouting, we are finished. Who can deliver us from this God? We remember what he did to Egyptians. What he did to this. Are you following me? Then all of a sudden, one of them said, well, even if we are going to die, let's fight. Are you following me? Rather than kill ourselves, let's fight. Let's not give up yet. Now give me, it's there. 1 Samuel chapter 4 verse 9. They said, be strong and quit yourselves like men. O ye Philistines, that ye be not servants unto the Hebrews as they have been to you. Quit yourselves like men. Fight! Because the fact is, they never knew that God was not with Israel. You remember the prophecy of Samuel to Eli? Are you following me? That the ark is just, they brought the ark does not mean it will happen. What I'm saying is, the challenges you don't confront has a right to remain. You get the point? The situation you think is there to drown you Don't creep up on it, because God always have a way out for you. Amen? God always have a way out. They say, quit ye like men and fight. Can I hear you say fight? Fight for your liberty. Fight the fight of faith for your breakthrough. Don't give up on life. Glory to God. And that's why in Joshua 1 verse 6, what God told Joshua, be strong and very courageous. Three times going, be strong. Are you following me? Because challenges will confront you. Circumstances will challenge you. It is only what you fight you have a right to overcome. Amen? It is only what you fight you have a right to overcome. And God said to Joshua, be strong and of a good courage. And he repeated that three times in those verses. And this is because God knows that a lot of things will come to discourage you. A lot of things will come to rear their head as if there is no way you can go through. But if you stand your ground by faith and fight, victory of God will answer for you. Glory to God. Don't give up on life. You have to be brave and courageous if you want to be successful in life. You have to stand in faith. Amen? When everything is saying no way, faith will always make a way. To be brave, to be courageous. And that's why the next principle we are talking about is that of perseverance. Are you following me? To persevere. What does perseverance mean? I'll just read a few for you from the dictionary. It says, it is steady, persistent, in a course of action. Steady and persistent, no matter what is happening. In a course of action. A purpose or state, especially in spite of difficulties or obstacles or discouragement, that you still keep pursuing. Are you following me? You keep fighting the difficulties, the opposition, the obstacles. Another one says, it is continued effort to do or achieve something despite difficulty. You get my point? That is perseverance. I put it in your notes. Somebody says, perseverance is failing 19 times, are you following me, and succeeding the 28th time. You get the picture? You have failed 19 times, but you refuse to stop. And then you succeed the 28th time. That's perseverance. Jesus said it, offenses will surely come. Challenges will come. And what you do with them is what becomes of you. Many give up on them. Many try a little and stop. But it is only the persistent, the ones who persevere, that will eventually overcome. Amen? Glory to God. Do not quit or give up living. Focus on your life goal and fight for it. Hallelujah. And that's why I said today I'm tying two things together. Coupled with the law of perseverance is the law of faith in God. Do you understand me? Normally when we talk of success, we should have started with that, but I choose to close with it. Do you understand me? Your faith in God. Even faith itself is a fight. Paul said what? Fight the good fight of faith. My bishop will say faith is hard work. Faith itself is a fight. The law of faith. Glory to God. Have you thought of this? Perhaps it's happened to all of us here. Oh, something happens. Maybe your head is knocking. Your joints are knocking. The first thing most Christians do is run to the hospital, right? And then when the hospital is trying and nothing is working, then you remember to call somebody to pray. Is that not common? But we should be putting God first. Yeah? Even most of the people you call unbelievers, those who have told you there is no God, when they are at the point of death and they have tried everything, they look for somebody to pray. God don't want to be your spare tire. Are you following me? When it comes to the subject of success, we begin with them, we end it with them. Are you following me? Don't ignore him. Most in desperation will cry out to God. I haven't ignored him before. It doesn't work that way. As God's people, I want you to know that God is always there. Amen? Jesus said, I am what? The first and the last. The beginning, right? And the end. He wants to be there from the beginning to the very end. It's not to discard him and look for every alternative available, and when it fails, you now start crying to him. No. The law of faith. We need to see him as the very source of life. Amen. Everything comes from him. And that's the more reason we should hold on to him. Amen. And that is now how I want to round up this today's message, by using your commitment to God and your faith in God to tie all the principles together. Do you understand? You know, we've talked of a lot of principles. Most of those principles we talk as if it's just about you. God is not there, right? Persevere, be diligent, set the right goal. But let me now show us in closing how with God you tie all together. Jesus is Lord. I say Jesus is Lord. How do you set a goal for your life without God in it? Who made you in the first place? Who made you? Are you sure you know who made you? Because the way some of you are looking at me, you think it's from Yemen where they came from, and then they made you in another country where you don't even know which one is your country now, for example. Who made you? I'm not even looking at me. I'm not seeing anything. I'm just preaching. Who made you? Amen? Do you understand what I'm saying? If he is the one who made you, he has plans for you. Can I hear you say, God has plans for my life? I am not a mistake. He made me purposefully. Amen? So that means your goal, even from the beginning, are you following me? Is set in him and with him. He's setting the right goal in line with his plan and purpose for your life. Remember, from the beginning, not even of this series, when I started the success series, we defined what success is, if you remember. I don't even want to tempt you to tell me what it was. Since you couldn't tell me the one of last week, there is no way you'll be able to tell me the one of 2 months ago. Even if your computer, you are searching for it. What is success? We said, success is not determined by physical accomplishments or wealth. That's not all that determines success. If you remember, we said that from the beginning. It's not determined by the riches we have acquired. We said, true success is staying in one's own lane and fulfilling God's true purpose for one's life. That's true success. We define that from the beginning. So if it's going to be tied to God's own purpose for your life, it also means you set your goal, right, in line with that. You get my point now? You set your goal in line with it. When you look into the world today, the so-called successful people of the world live their lives focused based mostly on temporary and material objects, material acquisitions that have no endurance nor eternal significance. You remember Solomon, who touched everything, experienced all the pleasures of this world. He came to a conclusion. He said, I have seen that all is what? Vanity. Vanity upon vanity, all is vanity. Because all accomplishments outside of God is vanity. It's important to know, like I said from the beginning, what real success is. Many may have their bank account so full, but their lives empty. I know some of you like that. You say, I don't care, just give me the money first. That's why you see, they keep having and keep pursuing to have more. Right? Never satisfied, because it does not bring satisfaction. Amen? It does not bring satisfaction. When they acquire it, it never satisfied. Of course, there are those temporal pleasures, moments of excitement, we know that. But there is still an hunger within that could not be satisfied. In fact, many people don't even know what the root of that hunger is. But thank God we know. Many are forsaking God in their pursuit for earthly satisfaction, and God calls that evil. Come with me to Jeremiah chapter 2, verse 13. He said, for my people, who are his people? For my people have committed two evils. The first one, they have forsaken me, he said, the fountain of living waters. Fountain, that means where it comes from, unending. Right? You have a fountain, you forsake it. He said, they have now carried to them broken cisterns like basket to collect water. When you have fountain that you don't need to be collecting, just go and be enjoying, right? You now hear now another means that will never satisfy, broken cisterns that can hold no water. Then he began to talk. He said, can't they reason? I'm trying to paraphrase this. Because you should reason, if you have a fountain in your house, right? Fountain means it just keeps flowing. And you are still looking for what will not even work. Can't you reason? He said, is Israel a servant? Is he an unborn slave? Why is he spoiled? That's God was amazed, wondering. Why is he being spoiled? The long iron sword of running bear that made this land waste. He's looking at things scattered and he can't reason. Go to the next verse. He talks of all the people who are troubling him. Go to the next verse. He said, has thou not procured it, all this crisis, all these troubles, all this not having enough, has thou not procured it unto thyself, in that thou hast forsaken the Lord thy God? Did you see that? You bought it yourself. When he led you, by the way, you refused to let him lead you. You bought it by yourself. Don't worry, I don't want... Okay. Glory to God. God says it is evil to forsake him. Pursuing your way of success by yourself. You understand me? Trying to make it by yourself. You get my point? Well, where is God in all this? Trying to make it by yourself. He said it is evil. Seeking help and respite from other sources. It is evil. That's why I said you must define what constitutes real success. Because except you find the true meaning of success, your goal will be misplaced. You get the picture? Except you find the true meaning of success, the goal is misplaced. You'll be running after, chasing after shadows, chasing after the wind, running after things that cannot satisfy. I could go to Isaiah, but I'm not sure I want to go that route today. Isaiah said, why labor you for that which satisfies not? So what we are talking about is that the right goal in God sets the right direction for your life. Success is a destination. That's the ultimate result. It's where you finally arrive. And on that journey, you have a prosperous an enjoyable experience on the way. But don't try to accomplish it without God. Don't you dare try that you can make it without Him. My next topic next week will be with God, and I will show us what we're talking about. Glory to God. It is all in your covenant walk with God. Glory to God. How much of God is in your life and in the things that you are doing and in the things that you are pursuing, how much of God is in it. When you are with Him, you get His guidance. He directs your steps. Amen? He helps you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Because life has a purpose. Without divine guidance, you go the wrong way. Life has a purpose. There's a reason why you are here. And the ultimate of true success is you attaining to that. You have Paul said, I have finished my course, right? He knew what he was there for. You know, Jesus, they took him one day, they wanted to make him king. Wouldn't you like to be king? He ran away. He said, that's not why I'm here. If you don't know why you are here, they will make you someone else. You get my point? That's why you set the right goal in God. And that's where true satisfaction comes from. Amen? When he did two miracles, they said, no problem. They wanted to make him king without election. Amen? And the Bible says he just went his way. That's not the reason why I'm here. You must know what gives you that joy and attainment. When you are with him, you don't lack guidance. You don't lack his power. You don't lack his help. He supplies the things you need to go forward. It makes happen for you what you could not make for yourself. Amen? Because he sees all things. He knows all things. Hallelujah. When you are with him. When you are with him. Your commitment to God is what changes everything. Can I say, my commitment to God is what changes everything? That's what I'm saying. The horse, he said, is prepared against the day of battle, but safety is of the Lord. Is your commitment, you get the picture? Is your commitment to God that changes everything? While I was, in this period, I've read a lot of books on success, and you will hear the stories of, they gave the stories of some of the 10 richest men in America before the Great Depression. I know he's an historian, he's shaking his head. He says, 10 richest, and they all, some of them committed suicide, some of them died penniless. Are you following me? Because there is no God in it. If you see their story, it's sad. If you read their story, I don't want to go there, because if you read their story, it's sad. They were 10 richest. Some of them were borrowing money to the nation at one time or the other. But because God was not in that life, some of them committed suicide. Some of them died penniless. In fact, of the 10, there was not one that died with anything. Can you imagine? Stop chasing after shadows. Material things, acquisition, will never bring you fulfillment. And somebody say, okay, if I follow after God, how will I get this? Have you seen anybody who follow after God and died penniless? Glory to God. I read that, it was so sad. Your main goal now will be spiritual and not natural, and not material, sorry. To have God, to be led by Him, to live for Him. Are you following me? To be involved with Him, to find that fulfillment from within of being with God. Now I close as I put everything together. You have been able to set the right goal in the context of God's plan for your life, right? You have been able to put that together. Then your preparation, your studies is all tied up in Him through His Word. Through His Word. As a matter of fact, that's what God told Joshua, Joshua 1:8, this book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, for thou shalt meditate in it day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. He said, for then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and thou shalt have good success. This means your number one source of inspiration as you pursue your journey in life will be His Word. Amen? His Word. You get my point now? Because you are pursuing His plan and purpose for your life, you are doing what He wants you to do, you are fulfilling your role among community of men, but your main source of inspiration and motivation is His Word. And through it, you will gain relevance. Having your mind renewed. Having the mind of Christ. Not just an acquisition of material. Receive the knowledge of God. The Bible says, they that know their God, right? They shall be strong. They will do exploits. So in the business you are doing, in the life you are doing, through that knowledge, you begin to command exploits. Be motivated by God's words for due diligence. Motivated. Look at a man like Joseph. He was a slave, but he was motivated by his word. That's why his master's money never missed in his hands. Are you following? You get what I'm trying to say now? Though he was a slave, he suffered all the pain and the hazards of slavery. But he was still faithful. He was doing it as unto God. How can I do this and sin against my God? That is, I can't take my master's money. I want to do the job as it should be done. Because the word, do you get my point, becomes his motivation. Where you are working today, if you are working it in the light with the word of God, they will envy you. They will look for you. Because your faithfulness will be unrivaled. You get my point? Your commitment to go, to work in itself will be unrivaled. And coupled with the intelligence and the wisdom that God invites you with, when you do this, you will stand out. That's what we're talking about. That's the way to it. That when you say you are going, they say you are not going. You say, no, I think I'm leaving this job. They say, sit down. What do you need? Is it more money? We'll give you more money. You say, no, my time here is up. They say, no, your time can't be up. It's those stupid ones, they can go if they want. But you, no. My point, because you see, your motivation, are you following me? You are, if you let the word of God be your motivation, you will be celebrated wherever you are working. Because we said it last week, God hates laziness. Tell me which manager wants a lazy worker. Apostle. You say, I want to employ somebody, but I want the lazy ones. So that's what I'm saying. Are you seeing how we are tying it together now? When you let His word be your motivation and you are doing it as unto the Lord, you will come to discover that He releases His power and His favor into what you are doing. Jesus is Lord. I say Jesus is Lord. Hallelujah. He becomes your number one source of inspiration. He becomes motivated by His word for due diligence and drive. He commands what you do, and you do it also with all your mind, because the Bible says, whatsoever your hands find to do, do it with all of your mind. And you are doing your work, being motivated by the word, there is no way you can fail. There is no way you will not be promoted there, even if the devil is the manager. All this one you are saying, my manager doesn't like me. That's not the real reason. When you are doing it motivated by the word, are you following me? There is a story of a young man in Chicago. It's a very serious case. He works for a company, and he was a director, but under a vice president. You know, most of the American companies can have 20 vice presidents, the way they do their work. And he was the one doing this job. Very intelligent young man. But the vice president is the one that will take the report to present up there. but never mentioned him. Using him, you know. And all of a sudden, and at the same time, he was being tormented by the vice president. Because I went to preach in their church and the pastor told me and brought him. And I said, don't worry, you will take his place. Since you are the one doing the job, you will take his place. And mysteriously, one day, they went to their board meeting and the vice president was presenting all those things. And one of their bosses just said, the way you are reading this thing, you are not the one who prepared this note. Who prepared this note? Who prepared this report? We want to see him. Let him come and present it himself. And then they brought this man. And you know the funny thing? His name is Jesus. He's the only black man that I see they call Jesus. He's from Ghana. His name is Jesus. His sister is Angel. His brother is Holy Ghost. That's how their father names them. And they brought him like they brought Joseph. You remember? They called Joseph. They said, the Lord is looking for, the king is looking for you. They brought him and he presented it. The long short of the story is, before you know it, they fired the vice president, they put him there. You know, Americans like who will get them results. They are not like Africans, so that he's my brother. He just has to be my brother, you know. He's my brother's village. We are from my tribe. So whether he's killing it, it doesn't matter. He has to be there. These ones, the number one God in America is called money. You can make the money for them, they want you. Amen. That's what I'm saying. When you do it with the word as your motivation, it may take time, but you will be exalted there. Amen. Because as you start doing it that way, he starts releasing his grace, he starts releasing his power, amen. He starts releasing his favor and begin to make things work for you. This week we'll look at it, doing it with God. Amen. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. When as a businessman, you had the motivation from the world, see as that a man that is diligent in his business, he will stand before kings, right? And not before men. And you put the forces of diligence, are you hearing me, into your work. That word will find expression in your life. That's what we're talking about. Success is not just making it, it is making it with him. It is making it as his, making it as his, with his word as your motivation. It is making it with his wisdom, finding expression through you. It is making it with his power working through you. Amen. And fulfilling your purpose here. Jesus is law. We learned a lot from the word. We learned of the wisdom of the hand. You remember? He said, go to the hand, you sluggard, which having no king or ruler, are you following me, prepares his meat in summer, because you know winter is coming that he can't do anything. We learn how not to be sluggish. And when you begin to put all that, how to be faithful in that which is another man's, so that you can get your own. That's what we are talking. Now that you allow his word, are you following me, in the things that you are doing as your main motivation, the power of God begins to make ways for you. No matter how intelligent or resourceful anyone is, he still needs the wisdom of God in handling the issues of life. Whether in business or whatever, through your contact with God, in the quietness of your prayer room, he infuses you with power to live. Amen. Isaac, after the death of Abraham, began to do things with a lot of opposition. The Bible says, we dig this well, they will take it from him, right? But he never stopped. That's the key. They strove with him. He kept going until he found springing water. Do you know, don't think springing water is better than well? If he had stopped because they fought him over the wells, he wouldn't get to springing water. Perseverance. Whatever he's trying to tell you, to stop you, tell him, you can't stop me. Remember what I said about perseverance? He said, perseverance is failing 19 times. And succeeding the 20th. Some people fail 3 times, they stop. They can't be happy. Benjamin Franklin failed 999 times. 999. That's F9 squared. Do they still do F9? Amen. Don't tell her that one. She can't do F9. That's our secret. F9, F10. Are you following? It's not how many times you fail. Keep pressing. Amen? That's the force of perseverance. The Bible says the righteous falls 7 times. He still stands up. Eh? Don't give up on life. Your breakthrough is about bursting forth. That's the fight of faith. Are you following me? That's the fight of faith. Anybody who is laughing, let them laugh at you, but just keep pressing. Amen? Joseph was pressing in Potiphar's house. They thought his breakthrough has come. They put him in prison. But he kept pressing. You get my point? He kept letting the word, that's my goal, be his motivation. If you are put unjustly in prison, would you be angry? Would you be bitter? Yet the word of God forbids you to be angry. The word of God forbids you to be bitter. The word of God says rejoice evermore. So you can rejoice even in prison. Let the word be your motivation. He was faithful even in prison. Somebody who is in prison unjustly should not be, right? But he allowed the word of God to be his motivation. Then one day, can I hear you say one day? One day, they said, the king is looking for you. Jesus said, what are you talking about? I don't know the king. I've never come across him. They say he's looking for you. How did he know about me? He's irrelevant. The king is looking for you now. Just one day. That day is about to break forth for you. That's what we're talking about. Perseverance. Perseverance. When you keep faithful, doing it his way, doing it his will. When you keep faithful, establishing your way in his will, one day it will break. May today be that day for you. In so doing, you secure his mercy. In so doing, you secure his help. In so doing, you secure his guidance. And as you walk in obedience to his will, don't you hear the Bible says, if you be willing and obedient, you will heed the good of the land. Amen. It is not who you are working for. It is not where you are working. It is how you are working it. And what is your motivation? What is your motivation? What is your motivation? Even when you are self-employed, what is your motivation? And if you don't know what to do, remember the Bible says, if any lack wisdom, let him ask. So you ask him. You ask him. Amen? You ask him. Leaving it after his order. And he gives you wisdom. And as you demonstrate your faith in God, God simply works out situation for you. Amen? Who knew that Joseph will meet the man that will take him to the king through the prison? Huh? That's why you keep persevering. You get my point? That's why you keep pressing. That's why you don't give up on life. That's why you don't give up on God. That's why you let the word be your motivation no matter what is happening. Amen? You let the word be your motivation no matter what is happening. Live according to the word. Let the word be your motivation. And then your breakthrough will be enforced. That's why Jesus says, he that endureth to the end, the same shall be saved. Say, I don't believe in those who put their hands in the plow and look back. He says, such is not fit for the kingdom. The kingdom of God is a kingdom of fighters. Those who fight the faith fight. Amen? Those who fight the faith fight. Jesus is Lord. You will make it. Your success will speak loud and clear for all to see. The hand of the Lord will move you forward. The favor of God will enlarge your coast. The mouth of God will speak on your behalf. Perseverance and faith. And your walk with God. Next we will talk on walking with Him. And you see how everything begins to come together. It's your time. You will enjoy good success. Can I hear you say, I will enjoy good success. I will go forward in life. The work of my hands will blossom. Rise up on your feet. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We bless your name, mighty God. Give Him praise and ask for His wisdom to be imparted upon your life this morning. Give Him praise. Give Him praise. Thank Him for His word. His word. We thank you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. Thank you for the release of grace here today. Thank you for making it happen for us here today. Thank you for favor that is impacted upon lives here today. We give you praise in the name of Jesus. Lord, I'm asking for your great hand, your almighty hand, to come upon these lives. And in coming upon them, to begin to work for them and work their favor in their fears of life in the name of Jesus. This week will answer for you. Favor will speak for you. Doors will open to you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Put your hands together as you take.